pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
Hey, Frontier, welcome back to the Friday News. We have a pretty good Friday News for you. It's been a pretty busy week, so we have a reminder that there's no school on Monday for Indigenous Peoples Day. There's national news, school news, and sports updates. We also have some new PSAs about vending machines and gum on trays, and Frontier Boys soccer clips, which are very exciting. So we hope you enjoy. Have a great day, Frontier.
Hello, Frontier. How are we doing? I'm doing pretty good, thanks. You know, it's me, Isaac, and I'm here reporting about the Bronx flooding. So recently, New York, the Bronx, they had a big flood come and struck them. And it was one of the worst ones they've seen in a very long time. The dirty water was knee high, maybe even like higher sometimes. It caused significant damages across train stations, like busy roads, houses, everything really. And the issue is the water in New York is not of the most sanitary, so it was very dirty and toxic. We wish the people in New York the best, and that's all. So yeah. Hello, Frontier, how are you doing? My name is Isaac, and I'm here to report about the situation that happened in the Canadian Parliament. They invited a former Nazi SS veteran from the 14th Waffen Division, and basically they awarded him because they were giving out awards when the Ukrainian President Zelensky visited. However, someone pointed out that he was a former Nazi. However, the Prime Minister, Justin Trudeau, he apologized about the whole situation, is trying to de-escalate it, you know, making it not a big deal. So it's not too good, is it? Anyways, I'll see you later.
Hello, Frontier. My name is Iris. And this week, make sure to celebrate the freedom to read by choosing a banned book this week. In the past few years, more and more communities in the states are banning books from schools, classrooms, and libraries, preventing students from reading these thoughtful and diverse books. This censorship is on the rise, but here at Frontier, we do not censor books. Frontier celebrates the freedom to share, to read by sharing books with different perspectives and ideas. We believe that all voices should be heard, all perspectives shared, and we learn together by having valuable discussions about these texts. To learn more, please visit the library and check out our banned book display. Thank you, Frontier.
What's up, Frontier? On Saturday evening, the Senate overwhelmingly passed a measure to temporarily avert a government shutdown by authorizing funding until November 17th. The House passed the bill earlier in the day, crossing the required two-thirds threshold with 335 votes, 209 Democrats, and 126 Republicans.
Hello, Frontier. How are you doing? I am back, and I got some good news for you guys. So, there's going to be no school October 9th, which is a Monday, due to Indigenous Peoples Day.
Indigenous Peoples Day, which honors and celebrates Native American people and history, really took root at a UN International Conference on Discrimination in 1977. South Dakota was then the first U.S. state to recognize the day in 1989. Today, 14 states, plus the District of Columbia, and more than 130 cities observe Indigenous Peoples Day instead of or in addition to Columbus Day.
Also formerly known as Christopher Columbus Day. So make sure you don't pull up to school. There's gonna be no one here, so you know. I hope you guys have a great Monday. And a Friday. Just have a great long weekend in general. I'll see you guys later. Toodles.
Hey, Frontier. Today I'm gonna educate you on something that I just learned about. I think it's pretty cool. It's called the Take the Money and Run style of artwork. It is a piece of artwork by Jens Hanning, commissioned by the Kunsten Museum of Modern Art, Aalborg, in Denmark, in 2021. The artwork consists of an empty canvas intended to act as a commentary on poor work wages. And you may ask, how much is this artwork worth? Well, let me tell you, an artist took $84,000 in cash from a museum and handed in blank canvases titled Take the Money and Run. He's been ordered to return some of it. In 2021, a Danish artist was given $84,000 by a museum to use in a work of art. and he found a clever and devious use for the cash. He pocketed it. Well, Frontier, I hope you learned something. Have a great day.
Hey everybody, as the sign says, it's poetry slam time. So what that means is that I need you to come by my room and sign up for the Poetry Slam Club so we can start having meetings, developing your poetry, and decide on a date when we can actually have the event. So the time is now. Come to my room, sign up, and let's get this thing going because we need to knock it out of the park yet again.
Salsa.
Merengue, maybe.
Bachata. Hey, te gusta bailar?
Me gusta bailar.
All right, tell your friends.
Let's tell my friends and my family.
And your family. Everyone's welcome. Gracias. Adios.
Hey, Frontier. I'm here with
Amanda, Sharon.
And she's a new teacher to the school. So, Ms. Sharon, where did you come from?
I came from Chicopee Comprehensive High School, where I taught for 8 years.
I'm pretty sure we just beat them in a game.
Soccer.
Yeah.
I heard.
How are you liking Frontier?
I'm loving it. I'm really excited to be here and just loving everything about it so far.
Perfect. Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Hey Frontier, it's Raquel here, just with a PSA for the whole school. If you have gum, gum deserves to be in the trash and not on your trays. So let's throw it in the trash, not on our trays, please.
I'm here with
Haley,
and I'm here with
Molly, and we're going to ask you some questions about field hockey. How's the season going so far?
Our record is 3-4-4. We're very young, but I think we're a very strong team. How's your season going? What's your record?
It's going good right now. We are 4-4-1, and our senior night is October 16th, so you all should come.
Hello, Frontier. I am Delaney, and I am here with
Claire.
Claire is a captain of the field hockey team, and she is going to tell us about the season so far.
Tonight is senior night at 7, so we play Belchertown, and we're going to win.
How's the season looking ahead?
It's pretty good. We got like 6 or 7 games left, and we're 16th right now in the state tournament, so that's not too bad.
Thanks, Claire.
Hey, Frontier. I'm Kaizik, and I'm here with
Iris.
And Iris is one of the captains of the girls' cross country team, and she'll be updating us with her team's record and games, matches, and updates.
All right, so we are currently 9-0 right now. We had a tough meet against Gateway the other day. We pulled the win. We got a lot of good young runners, and yeah, I think we have a good shot at league, and hopefully we'll make it to states.
Yeah, that's awesome. Great to hear.
Hey, Frontier. We're back with Mr. Vendetti. I have some questions for you, Mr. Vendetti. What is something that makes you feel unstoppable?
Ooh, something that makes me feel unstoppable. I think it's like in class when everybody's engaged, focused, having a good time, learning at the same time. It feels pretty awesome. Yeah.
That sounds amazing. Are you a good gift giver?
I would say no. I would say I struggle to give good gifts because either I go way overboard or way underboard. And so I can't really find that good middle ground, unfortunately. Yeah.
Do you often give people second chances?
Yeah, I think so. Actually more than second chance. I think, you know, seventh grade is all about multiple chances. Getting you ready, making mistakes is definitely okay. So, yeah.
Have you ever experienced deja vu?
I'm experiencing it right now, actually. I feel like I've been interviewed before. It's weird.
Wow.
It's so strange, yeah.
Well, it's good to be back. Thank you, Mr. Vendetti. All right. We appreciate it.